Time now for the Honda Sports Desk with ESPN 106.3 on WPTV News Channel 5.
We're going to stick with the fine arts. We've just seen dance, but now I hear we have poetry.
Yes, we do. Kelly Bidlin and myself, Kelly being our executive sports producer, worked very hard on this. It's only 4 seconds long, but we worked about 25 minutes on this.
Do it, please.
No joke.
Go.
All right, here we go. 'Twas the night before the Boca Raton Bowl, and all through the 5-6-1. Not a herd or Husky fan was sleeping, because they're out having some fun. Not bad, right? I even wrote down on my script, I'm a poet, and didn't know it.
You really are.
Thank you, everyone. Thank you. All right, the game, it's 19 hours away. It is time for a pep rally, and at City Place in West Palm Beach, the Northern Illinois Marching Band showing out for the people. Both teams getting their fans fired up tonight before history is made tomorrow at the first ever bowl game in Palm Beach County. Hey, Tuesday afternoon, both teams sharing the same room with each other during the Boca Raton Bowl team luncheon. Yeah, it's a big deal, too, when ESPN West Palm's Evan Cohen is your MC. Lots of highlights during the event, including football legend Howard Schnellenberger receiving the first ever Palm Beach County Legends Award. And after grabbing a bite, players and coaches catching up with the media one final time before kickoff. Outside of the college football playoffs, this is the only game to feature a pair of conference champions, which is why both head coaches expect a big-time battle on Tuesday night.
You know, our ultimate goal was to play the best possible team we could play, and we got that wish. I mean, Northern Illinois is a tremendous football team. I think for this bowl game to have two conference champions in it their first year, have two teams that won a total of 23 games, I mean, that's huge.
What a blessing to be here. I mean, beautiful Florida, unbelievable matchup, great bowl. Really, what more can you say?
While all that's going on, the coaches' wives are treated to Ladies' Day. It starts with lunch at the Breakers, followed by a trip up Worth Avenue to hang out at Hamilton Jewelers. A beautiful thing, guys. Coaches, your next bank statement. Not so much.